Welcome again, Electric Force Part 2, Incubation Academy. In the previous video, we have seen that how we calculate electric force if the two charges are separated by a distance according to the Coulomb's law, that is the force is equal to Q1 Q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon r square. If I want to associate the directions with it, then we can see that the force is acting along the line joining these two charges, and it is depending on what the charges on which I want to calculate the force, it feels the force in which directions it want to move. So depending on this, the direction is measured, just like there when I have done in the case of F12 vector and F21 vector. At that time, how they are calculated, I think you understood this thing. Since the electric force is originates due to the intrinsic property of a substance, that is the charge, similarly, if the bodies have the masses, then the gravitational force also originates. But the one thing should kept in mind that the gravitational force is always attractive in nature, but the electric force may be attractive, may be repulsive, depending on what amount of charge and what is the nature of the charges that are placed or separated by a particular distance. So here, two equal charges are placed in air and separated by a distance 2 meter repel each other. That means two equal charges from the line, we can understood that since the two equal charges repel each other, that means here two charges are of same nature, either both are positive or both are negative, and with a force 10 to the power minus 4 kilogram force or kgf. So kilogram force is nothing but the gravitational unit of the force. We can convert the gravitational unit of the force to the absolute unit by multiplying the value of acceleration due to gravity with it. So after that, calculate the magnitude of either of the charges. Here the magnitude of either of the charges we have to find out. So you just see F equal to 10 to the power minus 4 kilogram force. I just multiply the 9.8, because kilogram force is in the SI unit, so I multiplied 9.8, which is also the SI unit, so of G. So we get F equal to 9.8 into 10 to the power minus 4 newton, and this force is equalizes by the electrostatic repulsive force between the two equal charges. Since the two charges are equal, so Q1 and Q2 both are Q, we consider. So Q square divided by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 square, because 2 is the separation between these two charges. So Q square equal to 4 pi epsilon naught 2 square 9.8 into 10 to the power minus 4. Since 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9, so 4 pi epsilon naught equal to 1 by 9 into 10 to the power 9. If we replace this in this equation, and since we have to find the Q, so if we square this equation, we'll get the value of the charge 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb. But one thing I want to tell you, since both the charges are equal, their nature is not told, yet the magnitudes you have to find out, so this answer is correct. But if it is asked that what is the nature of these two charges, then their Q equal to, then the answer will be Q equal to plus minus 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb. At that time, you have to tell either both of the charges are positive or both of the charges are negative, because in the question it is written that two equal charges placed in air separated by a distance 2 meter repel each other. The repulsion occurs only when the nature of the two charges are same. Two equal charges placed in air separated by a distance 3 meter repel each other with a force 0.1 gf. That is the CGS unit of the gravitational force. The gravitational unit of the force in CGS unit system, I want to say. So 0.1 gram force again can be converted into the absolute unit by multiplying the g, that is the acceleration due to gravity. So if I want to do, then F equal to 0.1 gf gram force equal to 0.1 into 980, that is the value of the acceleration due to gravity in the CGS unit system. So it becomes dyne. So if we want to convert it, the dyne into newton, we know that 1 newton equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne. So here we multiply this 98 by 10 to the power minus 5. So it becomes in newton. And this force is equalizes by the repulsive force between the two equal charges, which are separated by a distance 3 meter. So capital F equal to Q1 Q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square. So the force is given 98 into 10 to the power minus 5. Since both the charges are equal, so you can place Q square into 9 into 10 to the power 9, because 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is 9 to 10 to the power 9. So we can replace it, and the distance between them is 3 meter, so it becomes 3 square. So Q square equal to 98 into 10 to the power minus 4. If we calculate this thing, then Q equal to 10 to the power minus 14, sorry, then Q equal to 9.89 into 10 to the power minus 7. Here also in this question it is asked calculate the magnitude. If they are asking the nature, then Q equal to plus minus 9.89 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb. Then either both the charges are positive or both the charges are negative. How far apart should two electrons be if the force exerts on the other equals to that of the weight of the electron? Since the two electrons are of negative charge, so the force exerts on each other is equal to the repulsive force between them, and that is if we follow the Coulomb's law, that is Q1 Q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square, then it becomes E square divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square, and that is equal to the weight of the electron. So if we equalize E square by 4 pi epsilon R square to that of the weight of the electron, that is MEG, then we can say that the R square is equal to E square by MEG into 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. So if I replace the value of the charge of the electron, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, and if I replace the mass of the electron, that is 9.18 into 10 to the power minus 31, then and 4 pi epsilon naught equal to 1 by 9 into 10 to the power 9. So if I replace all of these things and do the calculation, then the distance becomes approximately 5 meter. So you should remember these things, because some values you have to remember for the competitive exams, because in case of competitive exams all the time the calculations is not possible. So some symmetric values, some very regular or popular values you have to remember. Just like here, if the two charges, two electronic charges are separated by a distance, at that time this repulsive force between them, repulsive force between the two equal charges is equal to that of the weight of one electron, then the separation between them should be 5 meter. Two identical balls each have the mass 10 gram. Calculate the amount of charge in each ball so that their interaction equalizes the force of universal gravitation acting between them. Now I want to say that I have told previously at the starting of this lecture that the gravitational force is the attractive force, but the electrostatic force, depending on the nature of the charge, may be attractive, may be repulsive. It depends on the nature of the charge. Here two bodies are placed. So due to the gravitational force are acting along the line joining these two bodies and acting always towards each other. If we place both the charges on these two bodies are of same nature, then there will be a repulsion. that is the direction, that is the direction of the electrostatic force of repulsion is obviously away from each other. It wants to pull them away from each other, while the gravitational force wants to pull in. So the gravitational force and the electrostatic force are opposite to each other. That's why there is a question of reaching the steady equilibrium. If the steady equilibrium is reached only when the G mod M2 by R square is equal to Q square divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square. So Q square equal to 4 pi epsilon naught G M square, since both are identical here. So Q equal to M 4 pi epsilon naught G. Here plus minus should be given. If the plus minus if we replace, then we can say that if for the case of repulsion, either both the charges are positive or both the charges are negative. If I replace all these values here, that is the mass of each identical ball is 10 gram and the other constant, that is root over of 6.67 in 10 to the power minus 11, that is the gravitational constant, universal gravitational constant, and 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 0 equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9, then we can get this equation. And from it we have to remember what is the value of the ratio of the universal gravitational constant to that of the proportionality constant of the Coulomb's law in free space, and that is of the order of 1.34 into 10 to the power 20 here. So if I replace all of these things, then we get 8.608 into 10 to the power minus 13 Coulomb. So from this, the previous problem, we have to conclude one thing, and this conclusion is very important regarding to the short questions and the competitive, that if the two equal charges are of same masses are separated by a particular distance, then the charge to mass ratio, and if there is obviously in steady equilibrium, then the charge to mass ratio is given by root over of capital G divided by capital K. Capital G is the from the origin of gravitational force, it is the universal gravitational constant, and capital K is from the origin of Coulomb's force, that is the 9 into 10 to the power 9. So if I replace all of these things here, then just see what is the value of the Q by M here, and you have to remember this thing. Now here I have said that the steady equilibrium is achieved, that is the Coulomb repulsion is equal to the gravitational attraction. Here I have not said this, I have to find out what is the ratio of the Coulomb repulsion divided by the gravitational attraction. So if the two equal charges and of same mass, if I replace this, then just see the electric force divided by the gravitational force equal to K by G equal to Q square by M square. Okay, the calculation shows it. It is very easy to see, because the separation between the two particles or bodies here, it's same. If I calculating the gravitational force or if I calculating the electric force. So if both are the electrons, then the value K by G is always a constant value. So if I just know the charge to mass ratio, that is E by ME for the electron, then we get that is 10 to the power 42 times. If I take both our protons or neutrons, at that time we have to use the value of the charge to mass ratio for proton, and that will be of the order of 10 to the power 16. So if we replace it, then you can see it becomes of the order of 10 to the power 36. There it is of the order, in the case of electron, it is of the order of 10 to the power 42. But here in this case, it is of the order of 10 to the power 36. Because maybe the, not maybe, the electron and the proton shares the same value of charges, that nature is opposite, but the masses are different. The mass of the proton is 1836 times that of the mass of the electron. Since K by capital G is a constant, it is a universal ratio of the constant of proportionality of the Coulomb's law and that of the constant of proportionality from the Newton's law of gravitation. So these will never change. So in case of free space or whatever it be, I want to say that K by G is a constant. If I just take it as a constant, then the ratio of the electric force to that of the gravitational force is proportional to the square of the charge to mass ratio. That is a very good implications or shortcomings from the this understanding and from this type of problems, that the relation, that is relation between the electric force and the gravitational force. The charge to mass ratio, I want to say the charge to mass ratio in steady equilibrium is also the square root of K by G. Here also it is said that the electric force to the gravitational force is proportional to the square of the charge to mass ratio. This is a very good shortcomings, or I guess not shortcomings, this is the very good implications, and you need to remember this thing, because then lot of calculations can be avoided. What amount of charges should be placed on the earth and the moon so that the gravitational force of attraction force is nullified by the electrostatic repulsion? Here the charges, the earth and the moon are both are contain different amount of charges, that is I can show the Q, both are Q, and I have to find out what is the value of the Q. Then here it is said the Fe by Fg equal to K by G, Q1, Q2 into M1, M2. There I have considered in the previous problem, both the particles are of same charge and the same mass, then we get the square of it. If I say that it is not of same mass and same charge, then the product of the charges and product of the masses should be used. So Fe by Fg equal to capital K by G equal to product of the charges and the product of the masses. So if I replace this thing, Fe by Fg equal to 1. Why? Because it is said they are in steady equilibrium, or it is nullified by each other. If it is nullified by each other, Fe by Fg should be equal. If Fe by Fg is equal, then it is equal to 1. So 1 equal to K by G equal to Q square divided by 10 to the power 25, which is the mass, which is the order of the mass of the earth, and 10 to the power 23, which is the mass order of the mass of the moon. If we replace these things, then the Q gives us 8 into 10 to the power 13 coulomb, and that is the value of the charge that should be placed on the earth and the moon, so that the electrostatic repulsion between the moon and the earth neutralizes the gravitational force between the earth and the moon. And just think, if it happens, if this thing happens, if somehow it takes place, then the moon will be liberated from the gravitational attraction force of the earth. These are really very topological problem. I want to say that these are basically the thought experiments. Now another problem is given for you. Calculate the magnitude of the electrostatic force exerted by the proton and proton on electron in the hydrogen atom and compare it with the weight of the electron. This type of problem is done in the previous cases, so I just left it for you. A free pith ball of 8 gram carries a positive charge 5 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb. What must be the nature and the magnitude of the charges that should be given to a second charge placed 5 cm vertically below the former pith ball so that the upper pith ball is stationary? Just see, Q1 is the upper pith ball, Q2 is the lower pith ball. Q1 holds the charge a 5 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb and its mass is 8 gram. Another charge Q2 whose charge is not known, value of the charge is not known. It is placed at a distance 5 cm below it. So here the electrostatic repulsion which is acting upwards between Q1 and Q2 is neutralized by the weight of the mass M1 or the particle 1 that is placed above the particle 2. So Fe equal to M1G. From that, if we just equalize this thing, Fe equal to Mg, we get Q2 equal to 4 pi epsilon naught r square M1G divided by Q1. So if I put the values, that is the that is the charge of it, if I put all the values, then we get the answer 4.36 into 10 to the power minus 7, and the nature of the charge should be positive, otherwise the repulsion will not occur. If this value of the charge is, it is the value of the charge, if it is negative, then it will also attract this particle 1 towards the particle 2. At that time, the weight and the electrostatic attraction in the same direction. If they are in the same directions, there will be no question of attaining the equilibrium. Another question is for you. A pith ball of mass 9 into 10 to the power minus 5 kg carries a charge 5 microcoulomb. Find out the magnitude and the sign of the charge placed at a distance 2 cm directly above it if it remains the stationary. The same type of problem again it is given. It is for you. Estimate the number of electrons in 100 gram water. How much is the total negative charge in electrons? Basically, one water molecule contains two hydrogens and one oxygen. One hydrogen contains, if I say the protium isotope, it contains one electron. And one oxygen contains 8 electrons. So, in total, one water molecule have 10 electrons. According to the concept of mole, I want to say that the 18 gram H2O contains 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 H2O molecules. So we have to calculate 100 gram H2O contains what amount of H2O molecules. We just follow the inventory method and it gives 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 into 100 divided by 18 H2O molecules. Each H2O molecules contain 10 amount of electronic charge. So 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 into 100 divided by 18 into 10. And each negative charge here have the value 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Obviously a negative sign there. If we replace all the values here, we get minus 5.35 into 10 to the power 6 coulomb. And that is the total negative charge in a 100 gram water if we consider the charge of the electrons. Now, the question is, in the just the continuation of the previous problem, if the total positive charges and negative charges lumped at two places and they are separated by a 10 centimeter, that is, since the water is a neutral molecule, so the amount of positive charge and the amount of negative charge is should be equal. So we consider the amount of positive and negative charge, whatever be it, the magnitude of it is 5.35 into 10 to the power 6. So plus Q and minus Q is separated by a distance 10 centimeter. So if I replace all the values, just like 5.36 into 10 to the power 6 whole square into 9 into 10 to the power 9, and R is replaced by the 10 centimeter, that is 10 by 100, we get the force is this. Now it is said that compare it with the weight. What is the weight of the 100 gram water? That is 100 divided by, there should be 100 divided by 1000 kg into, it is 100 only written there, you just correct, make it correct. So it will be 100 divided by 1000, that is 9.8 newton, that is 0.98 newton. So F by W will be something else. F by W will be, I think, 2.63 into 10 to the power 24 then. So from here we can understood that how the electric force is equalizes the gravitational force, and in which cases, different cases are taken here, and in that case the q square divided by 4 pi epsilon r square is equal to that of the g inbound m2 by r square. Sometimes it is equal to weight, sometimes it is equal to the kgf or gf, that is the gravitational unit of the force. In all of the cases, if it says the steady equilibrium or the neutralization, at that time the two forces magnitude should be equal and both of them are acting in the opposite direction. And from that one conclusions, and one important conclusions that we find out, that we find out that here, that if the two equal charges and equal masses are separated by a distance, particular distance, and if they are in steady equilibrium, because the electrostatic force of repulsion and the gravitational attraction or pulling is in the opposite directions at that time, the charge to mass ratio is equal to that of the root over of k by g. It also says us that it is a constant value, the charge to mass ratio is a constant value. And another thing I want to say, if I want to find out the electrostatic force to that of the gravitational force, then it is equal to k by g into the product of the charges divided by the product of the masses, that is k by g equal to q1 q2 divided by m1 m2. I think this important conclusion should be kept in your mind, because these things helps you in doing the next type of problems in a within a very short period of time. Thank you.